Well, good afternoon, James. How are you?
Good afternoon. I'm good. How are you, Dad?
I'm fine. I sort of feel like I'm looking at a younger, better looking version of myself.
And a more bald version.
Well, you do have the genes of your mom's dad, Grandpa Herb. And I was talking to my mom, who I had breakfast with this morning, about how you maybe more than any of the kids show the Markham side, which is a good thing, I think. All right, so you're number five. What's it like being the youngest in a highly toxic family? I mean, really.
Honestly, there's a lot of things that I consider that being five to be kind of the best, even though like there's the stigma of being like the ignored one or like the one that gets all the hand-me-downs, which honestly is fairly true. But my parents were incredibly intentional. And like the last couple of like the last year when I was in high school, my parents, each of them would take me out to lunch on a different day. I think my dad did Monday, my mom did Fridays. Worship with mom. I feel like we connect quite a bit on that. And then with you, it's Denver Nuggets or sports or different things.
Yeah, we used to connect on the Denver Nuggets until they lost four in a row.
So I teach band and orchestra to middle schoolers up in Evergreen, Colorado, in Jefferson County, Jeffco. Been at Evergreen for about the last 3 years. It's been awesome. Today is the first official day of spring break and it snowed up here. And so it's just like, I love the community up here. I love what I do. I get to interact with middle schoolers on a daily basis and they're kind of insane and it's exhausting. And I often drive home without a voice and not really being able to talk. And just like, all I can do is just listen to instrumental music and just like sit back and like just breathe. The middle schoolers, especially up here, are just, they're very, very authentic to themselves, even if themselves is a little insane. and I love that they feel comfortable enough to be able to do that. Like even this afternoon, there was a girl that she started laughing so hard that she fell out of her chair and was on the ground and just like spazzing me back and forth. And she was just, everyone's like, are you okay? She's like, ah! And she's just laughing so hard just because, and she feels comfortable enough. And she talks about how she has issues in some of her other classes, but in the band room, she's able to like really, really just feel like she can express herself and not have to cover up.
Yeah.
Which is huge. And that's a big reason why I wanted to become a music teacher, is because I didn't have the best experience in middle school in terms of
who has.
Exactly. No, nobody does.
Because you're not afraid to set them straight, right? It's not like you're just Mr. Nice Guy all the time.
Yeah, I think sometimes I'm a little too nice to the point where I do have to come back hard, rebound hard the other way. They probably think I overcommunicate, but I'm saying, all right, this is the third time today that I've had to talk to you about this issue. Can you understand, coming from my point of view, why I need you to stop playing while I'm talking? Okay, so I'm not able to communicate. Okay, so now that you're able to understand that, do you understand why it's frustrating for me as an individual that you're doing this over and over and over again? And then, and if they're remorseful, usually I'll let up. But if they're like doubling down, I'm like, all right, so now you're putting away chairs and stands for the entire class today. Congratulations. I think that they're realizing that who they are is valuable and that they don't have to pretend to be somebody else. And I have a whole spiel on the first day of school that every time that I see a new student, I kind of give them a rundown of why I'm a teacher and that kind of thing. How out of everybody that's ever existed in the world, they are the only version of themselves to exist. And so that's important, because why would they try to be somebody else then? And then, so I just really, really focus on this idea of individuality and being able to be open and be yourself. They're so unsure of who they are. And so I want to let them know that who they are can shine through. Like they don't have to put a mask on. They don't have to like have this different idea of who they are. They can be themselves. And to a certain extent, we will accept them for that. And we'll love them and we'll go with it. And then we'll just be able to take time in the middle of the school day just to like have fun and make music.
Do you feel like you're giving them the kingdom of God somehow through that simple opening thing that you give them?
Oh, absolutely. Because no matter what, I reinforce this idea that that I really just love them for who they are. And it's difficult for me to use those words, I love you, especially to like a middle schooler. So usually it's in a group setting, just because I don't know, like I just like, right. I've always felt like, besides like platonically or like with parents, I've always struggled to say like, I love you to people. A lot of them don't get that from places.
Yeah.
For either that their parents aren't super, super involved or things like that. And so I feel like I have this ability to being able to be a figure that's able to demonstrate what love looks like.
Yeah.
In a healthy way.
You're creating a culture of acceptance and creativity.
And honestly, a big thing that I'm seeing in the current culture is this idea of like acceptance to the point where it's beyond accepting people for like what they do. It's like, I believe this, so you have to believe that that it's okay too. And so because of that, because there's core foundations of Christianity where like, this is what you believe. These are truths. These aren't. And so honestly, I think that I'm fairly like
it's a stability, a constancy, as opposed to rigidity, like intolerance kind of a thing.
Yeah, exactly. And so I'm able to be like, I am not allowed to be like, to like shout about my faith, but I'm open about it if they asked. So I talk about, they ask, especially in the music world, they'll ask me if I play gigs outside of work, and I'll be like, oh yeah, I play piano at my church. And I'm very open. Like if they ask questions, I'm very open about like, this is what I believe. And I've actually had a few conversations where I'm like, I'm not trying to push this on you at all because legally I'm not allowed to, but I'm like, this is what I believe. And I'm not trying to influence you in any way because that language, unfortunately, that language has to be incredibly clear.
Yeah.
But I think I'm able to show the gospel just through that.
Yeah. Yeah. I would think if you're creating an unconditional acceptance of love and honoring them as people and the gift and that they are, that's a powerful expression. So more power to you, buddy. That's cool. Thank you.
I've got my memories always inside of me, but I can't go back to how it was.